At the same time, Solomon kept the feast 7 days and all Israel with him, and a very great congregation from the entering in of Hamath unto the river of Egypt.
Ni akoko na pelu Solomon ni se ase na ni ijo meje ati gbogbo Israel pelu re ijo eniyan nla nla lati iwo Hamati titi de odo Egypt.
And verse 9, and in the 8th day they made a solemn assembly, for they kept the dedication of the altar 7 days and feast, and the feast 7 days.
Ese ikesan ati ni ojo kejo won se apejo mimo ni tori ti won se mimo apepe na ni ojo meje ati ase na ojo meje.
In all those scriptures that we have read,
ni gbogbo awon iwe mimo ti a ti ka yi,
and in many other scriptures that you could have read but because of time,
ati awon ese iwe mimo miran ti a o ba ka,
the issue of altars were mentioned in every one of them.
Ọ̀rọ̀ ti pẹpẹ ni wọ́n dárúkọ nínú gbogbo ibi tá a ti kà yìí.
The Bible spoke, for example, concerning Abraham.
Bíbélì sọ̀rọ̀ nípa ti Abrahamu nípa
tó. That when the Lord appeared unto him,
pé nígbà tí Ọlọ́run fara hàn,
he raised an altar.
Ó gbé pẹpẹ kan dìde.
And he poured oil on the altar.
Ó sì da òróró sí orí
pẹpẹ náà. And he called upon the name of the Lord.
Ìjọ ìrìn là ń pè ní pẹpẹ.
When an individual has a place that is dedicated to prayer, that is an altar.
Nígbà tí olórí ìjọrí ènìyàn bá ní ibi tó ti yà sọ́tọ̀ fún àdúrà, pẹpẹ là ń pè bẹ̀ náà.
An altar is a place where divinity, God meets with man.
Pẹpẹ jẹ́ ibi tí Ọlọ́run látòkè wá tó ń bá ènìyàn pàdé.
It is a place of encounter.
Ó jẹ́ ibi ìbápàdé.
The Bible says in Genesis chapter 28.
Bíbélì sọ nínú Genesis orí.
Let's look at it, Genesis chapter 28.
Genesis
in verse 18. Genesis chapter
28.
In verse 18. Maybe I should even start from verse. Let's start from verse 10.
Clarity.
And Jacob went out of Beersheba and went toward Haran.
Jacob was jade kuro lati Beersheba lo, o si lo si iha Harani.
And he lighted upon a certain place and tarried there all night because the sun was set. And he took up the stone of that place and put them for his pillows and lay down in that place to sleep.
O si de ibikan o duro nibe ni oru na nitori orun wo. Ó sì mú nínú òkúta ibẹ̀ náà, ó fi ṣe ìrọ̀rí rẹ̀, ó sì sùn níbẹ̀ náà.
And he dreamed a dream, and behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven, and behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it.
Ó sì láàlàá, sì kíyèsí, àgbẹ̀ àkàsọ̀ kan dúró lórí ilẹ̀, orí rẹ̀ sì dé òkè ọ̀run, sì kíyèsí, àwọn angẹ́lì ọlọ́kẹ̀, wọ́n sì ń sọ̀kalẹ̀ lórí rẹ̀.
And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham thy father, the God of Isaac. The land whereon thou liest to thee will I give it, and to thy seed.
Sì kíyèsí, Olúwa dúró lókè rẹ̀, ó sì wí pé, èmi ni Olúwa, Ọlọ́run Abrahamu bàbá rẹ̀, àti Ọlọ́run Isaaki, ilẹ̀ tí ìwọ dùbúlẹ̀ lé ni, ìwọ ni èmi ó fi fún àti fún irú ọmọ rẹ̀.
Verse 14, and thy seed shall be as the dust of the earth, and thou shalt spread abroad to the west and to the east, to the north and to the south, and indeed and thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed.
Irú ọmọ rẹ̀ yóò sì rí bí erùpẹ̀ ilẹ̀. Ìwọ ó sì tàn kálẹ̀ sí àìwọ oòrùn àti sí àìlà oòrùn àti sí àríwá àti sí àgúsù, nínú rẹ àti nínú irú ọmọ rẹ ni ó bùkún fún gbogbo ìbátan
yìí. And behold, I am with thee, and I will keep thee in all the places whither thou goest, and will bring thee again into this land. For I will not leave thee until I have done that which I have spoken to thee of.
Sì kíyèsí, èmi wà pẹ̀lú rẹ, èmi ó sì pa ọmọ ní ibi. Èmi ó sì tún mú ọbọ̀ wá sí ilẹ̀ yìí, nítorí èmi kì yóò kọ̀ ọ́ sílẹ̀ títí èmi ó fi ṣe èyí tí mo wí fún ọ tán.
And Jacob awake out of his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I knew it not.
Jacob sì jí ní ojú oorun rẹ̀, ó sì wí pé, Olúwa ń bẹ níhìn-ín nítòótọ́, èmi kò sì mọ̀.
And he was afraid and said, how dreadful is this place? This is none other but the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven.
Ẹ̀rú sì bá, ó sì wí pé, èyí ti ní ẹ̀rù tó, èyí kìí ṣe ibòmíràn, bí kò ṣe ilé Ọlọ́run, èyí sì ní ẹnubodè ọ̀run.
Verse 18, and Jacob rose up early in the morning, and took the stone that he had put for his pillows, and set it up for a pillar, and he poured oil upon the top of it.
Jacob si dide ni kutukutu owuro, o si mu okuta ti o fi se irori re, o si fi lele fun awon, o si ta ororo si ori re.
Jacob had an encounter with God on this particular spot.
Ni ikorita bi ti an soro yi ni Jacob ti se ni ibapade pelu Olorun.
And as a result of that encounter,
nitori ibapade yi,
the Bible says he set up stones.
Bibeli so wipe o gbe okuta
kale. And he poured oil on the top of it.
O si da ororo si ori re.
That was an altar.
Eleyi ni a n pe ni pepe.
Why was the altar raised?
Kilode ti a fi gbe pepe na
soke. Because there the Lord met with Jacob.
Nitori pe nibe ni Olorun ti ba Jacob
pade. So altar is a place where the Lord meets with human beings.
Pepe wa je ibi ti Olorun ti n ba awon eniyan pade.
Jacob was having the crisis.
Jacob ni awon idojuko.
He had to run away from Esau, his brother.
Oni lati sa kuro lodo Esau ara
ko. And he was running to Haran to go and meet his mother's family.
O si sa lo si ara ni lati lo patan mama re.
He was going on a journey that he was not sure what was going to happen.
O lo ni rajo to je pe ko mo nkan ti o sele.
But then the Lord met with him there.
Sugbon nibe ni Olorun ba pade.
And he said, surely this is the gate of heaven. This is the house of God.
O ni daju daju ile Olorun ni yi enubode Olorun.
And he built an altar to Lord there.
O si ko pepe sibe.
Thereafter he left to where he was going.
Leyin eyi o lo sibi to
lo. But the altar did not get out of his position.
Sugbon pepe yi ko kuro nibi ti a ti.
Later in life,
nigba to tun wa ya
ni when he was having problem with Laban,
nigba to ni soro pelu
Laban, the Lord reminded him.
Olorun ran leti.
He says, I am the Lord of I am the Lord that you met in the place where you met me.
Emi ni Olorun ti o ba pade nibi to ti ba mi pade.
I am the Lord of Bethel, because he called the name of that place Bethel.
Emi ni Olorun Bethel nitori pe o ko oruko ibe ni Bethel.
The Lord remembered the word that he spoke to Jacob while he was coming from his father's house to the house of Laban.
Olorun wa ranti oro to so fun Jacob nigba to n bo lati le baba re si odo Labani.
Altar is a place where man meets with God.
Pepe je ibi ti eniyan ti n ba Olorun pade.
It's a place where man make a conciliation with God.
Ibe ni eniyan ti soro ni asoro
ibalaja
Olorun ti ni ibe ni eniyan ti n ba Olorun
laja. Particularly when somebody has run contrary of God for his or her life.
Papa julo nigba ti eniyan ba ti se lodi ti ipinu Olorun ninu
aye re. When you come back to the altar,
nigba to ba pada wa ti
se pe. It's a place where you can reconcile with God.
O je ibi ti o ti le bo Olorun laja.
An altar is a place of worship.
Be ni pe ibi isin.
It's a place where sacrifices of praise are raised up as unto the Lord.
O je ibi ti a tin gbe awon eyin dide si Olorun.
It's a place where we worship God in spirit and in truth.
O je ibi ti a tin sin Olorun ninu emi ati ni otito.
It's a place where the priest in the Old Testament will offer worship unto God on behalf of the people and on behalf of themselves.
O je ibi ti awon alufa ninu majemu lailai ti won ti ma rubo si Olorun nitori ti awon eniyan ati nitori ti ara won.
And altar is also a place of covenant.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni pẹpẹ tun jẹ ibi majẹmu.
Several occasions in the life of Abraham.
Ni ọpọlọpọ igba ninu aye
Abraham. The Bible will say the Lord made a covenant with Abraham.
Bíbélì yóò sọ wípé Ọlọ́run sì dá majẹmu pẹ̀lú Abraham.
He built an altar unto the Lord.
Níbẹ̀ ni ó sì kọ́ pẹpẹ sí Ọlọ́run.
Look at an example in Genesis chapter 15.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká wo àpẹẹrẹ nínú ìwé Genesis orí kẹrìndínlógún.
Genesis chapter 15.
Genesis orí kẹrìndínlógún.
Look at verse 9 there.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká wo ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹsàn-án níbẹ̀.
And he said unto him, take me an heifer of 3 years old, and a she goat of 3 years old, and a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. Verse 9.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹsàn-án.
15:9.
Genesis 15:9.
Okay. Hallelujah. Ó sì wí fún pé, mú ẹgbọrọ màálù ọlọ́dún mẹ́ta fún mi wá, àti ewúrẹ́ ọlọ́dún mẹ́ta, àti àgbo ọlọ́dún mẹ́ta, àti oriri kan, àti ọmọ ẹyẹlé kan.
Verse 10.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹwàá.
And he took unto him all these and divided them in the midst, and laid each piece one against another, but the boss divided it not.
Ó sì mú gbogbo nǹkan wọ̀nyí wá sọ́dọ̀ rẹ̀, ó sì là wọ́n ní agbede méjì, ó sì fi ẹ̀là ìkíní kojú sí èkejì. Bí kò ṣe àwọn ẹyẹ ni kò là.
And when the fowls came down upon the carcasses, Abraham drove them away.
Nígbà tí àwọn ẹyẹ sì sọ̀kalẹ̀ wá sí orí òkú wọ̀nyí, Abraham lé wọn kúrò.
Verse 12, and when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abraham, and lo, an horror of darkness fell upon him.
Ẹ̀tẹ̀ ìkejìlá, ó sì ṣe nígbà tí oòrùn ń wọ̀ lọ, oòrùn ìjìká kun Abrahamu, ó sì kíyèsí ẹ̀rú bá òkùnkùn biribiri sì bò.
Verse 13, and he said unto Abraham, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years.
Ó ní ẹ̀tẹ̀ ìkẹtàlá, ó sì wí fún Abrahamu pé, mà nítòótọ́ pé irú ọmọ rẹ yóò ṣe àlejò ní ilẹ̀ tí kìí ṣe tiwọn, wọn ó sì sìn wọn, wọn ó sì jẹ wọn ní ìyà ní 400 ọdún.
Jump down to verse 18. In the same day the Lord made a covenant with Abraham, saying unto thy seed, have I given this land from river of Egypt unto the great river, the river Euphrates.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkejìdínlógún, ní ọjọ́ náà gan ni Olúwa bá Abrahamu dáhùn pé irú ọmọ rẹ ni mo fi ilẹ̀ yìí fún láti odò Egypt wá. Títí ó fi dé odò ńlá ni odò Ifrete.
So here Abraham raised an altar unto the Lord.
Ní ibi Abraham gbé pẹpẹ dìde
sí Ọlọ́run. And the Lord made a covenant with him.
Ọlọ́run sì dá májẹ̀mú pẹ̀lú rẹ̀.
I'm reading all this to let you know the importance of an altar.
Mo ń ka gbogbo àwọn ibi tí mo ń kà yìí láti jẹ́ kí ẹ mọ ìṣe pàtàkì
rẹ. When you have an altar that is raised unto the Lord.
Nígbà tí o bá ní pẹpẹ yìí tí o gbé dìde
sí Olúwa. There the Lord will meet with you.
Níbẹ̀ ni Olúwa yóò ti máa bá ọkàn
mi. There the Lord enters into a covenant with you.
Níbẹ̀ ni Ọlọ́run yóò ti wọ májẹ̀mú
pẹ̀lú rẹ. There the Lord makes a reconciliation with you.
Níbẹ̀ ni Ọlọ́run yóò ti máa mú
ìtẹ̀síwájú. You offer praises unto God.
Níbẹ̀ ló ti máa fi ìyìn fún
Ọlọ́run. Here divinity will meet its humanity.
Níbẹ̀ ni ọ̀run yóò ti máa bá ènìyàn pàdé.
I'm asking you tonight.
Mo wá ń béèrè lọ́wọ́ rẹ ní
àtàlẹ́. Do you have an altar?
Ǹjẹ́ o ní pẹpẹ kan bí?
For some people their altar is their bedside. For some people.
Fún àwọn ènìyàn kan. Ẹgbẹ́ ibùsùn wọn ni pẹpẹ wọn wà.
That is where they kneel down and they pray every morning they pray. Every evening.
Ibẹ̀ ni wọ́n ń kúnlẹ̀ sí lóròrò òwúrọ̀ tí wọ́n ń gbàdúrà bẹ́ẹ̀ náà ni ní ìrọ̀lẹ́ wọ́n kúnlẹ̀ síbẹ̀ wọ́n á sì gbàdúrà.
It becomes a place of appointment between themselves and their God.
Ó ti wá di ibi ìbápàdé láàrin wọn àti Ọlọ́run wọn.
And so God is looking forward to the time when you go to meet with him on the altar.
Ọlọ́run wa ń retí àkókò tí ó bá òun pàdé ní orí pẹpẹ.
And God is ready to meet with you on that altar.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni Ọlọ́run sì ti ṣetán láti bọ́ pàdé lórí
pẹpẹ. Altar is a place where you meet with God.
Pẹpẹ jẹ́ ibi tí o ti ń bá Ọlọ́run pàdé.
An altar is also a place of protection and comfort.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni pẹpẹ jẹ́ ibi ìdáàbòbò àti
ìtura. Particularly in the times of troubles.
Pàápàá jùlọ ní àkókò ìyọnu.
An altar is a place that you could is a place where intercession is made for the well-being of others people as inspired by the Holy Spirit.
Pẹpẹ jẹ́ ibi tí a ti ń ṣe ìsìnpẹ̀ fún ìwà láàyè lálàáfíà àwọn ẹlòmíràn gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹ̀mí mọ́ ti darí wa.
In the Bible each altar was built according to the significance that people give to that altar.
Nínú májẹ̀mú nínú Bíbélì gbogbo pẹpẹ tá a gbé dìde òun la gbé dìde gẹ́gẹ́ bí pàtàkì tí àwọn ènìyàn fi fún pẹpẹ náà.
Men of God build the altars in the Bible for God after he had done one thing or the other for them.
Àwọn ènìyàn Ọlọ́run wọ́n gbé pẹpẹ dìde sí Ọlọ́run lẹ́yìn ìgbà tó ti ṣe àwọn nǹkan pàtàkì kan sínú ayé wọn.
People that have significant impact for God and on his behalf.
Àwọn èèyàn ń ṣe nǹkan pàtàkì yìí.
The people who have significant impact.
Àwọn tó ní nǹkan pàtàkì.
For God.
Fún Ọlọ́run.
On the surface of the earth.
Ní orí ilẹ̀ ayé.
Are people that have altars where they meet with God.
Àwọn ni wọ́n jẹ́ àwọn èèyàn tí wọ́n ní pẹpẹ tí wọ́n
ń dé fún Ọlọ́run pàdé. Example Abraham.
Àpẹẹrẹ ni Abrahamu.
Example Isaac.
Àpẹẹrẹ ni Isaki.
Example Jacob.
Àpẹẹrẹ ni Jacobu.
Example Moses.
Àpẹẹrẹ ni Moses.
Example Solomon.
Àpẹẹrẹ ni Solomoni.
All of these ones have one significant impact they made on behalf of God on the earth.
Gbogbo àwọn ènìyàn tá a dárúkọ wọ̀nyí wọ́n ní nǹkan pàtàkì kan tí wọ́n ń ṣe nípa ti Ọlọ́run
lórí ilẹ̀. Each of them have an altar where he has an encounter with the Lord.
Gbogbo olúkúlùkù wọn ni wọ́n ní pẹpẹ níbi tí wọ́n ti ń bá Ọlọ́run pàdé.
There are different types of altar that can be raised.
Oríṣiríṣi pẹpẹ la lè gbé dìde.
You can have a personal altar.
A lè ní pẹpẹ ti
ara wa. Like the example I gave the other time.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí àpẹẹrẹ tí mo
fún wa. Some people's altar is by their bedside.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ pẹpẹ àwọn ènìyàn lẹ́gbẹ̀ẹ́ ibùsùn wọn ló wà.
Some people when they build their own house they have a place they call this is my prayer room that is their altar.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àwọn èèyàn bákan náà ni wọ́n nígbà tí wọ́n bá kọ́ ilé wọn wọ́n ní yàrá kan tí wọ́n yàsọ́tọ̀ pé ibi tí máa ti máa gbàdúrà ní pẹpẹ wọn nìyẹn.
And we can have family altar. where we gather together as a family in the morning and in the evening, and we pray and we look at the word of God and we seek the face of the Lord, and God meets with us on that altar. A church is an altar. Whenever we gather in the presence of God, we raise an altar unto the Lord. There can be national altar as well, where a nation has an altar with God, and there can also be negative national altar, where a nation has encounter with the demons and with the devils. The place where an herbalist make consultation, that is an altar. They raise several altars as occultic people. The altars they raise are not unto the Lord. The altars they raise are unto devils and unto demons. And they are so careful when they are on their altar. They don't do things that, according to them, desecrate their altars.
A
child of God must have his altar. And you must be careful the way you treat your altar, because you must not desecrate your altar. You don't bring unrighteousness unto your altar. Some brethren have their room that is separated unto God. They say, this is my prayer room. Some of them, they don't take their mobile phone into that place. Not because mobile phone is a sin, but they do not want any distraction. Why? They give a great importance to their altar. What do we do on the altars? You can sacrifice on altars. You can shed blood on altars like it was done in the Old Testament. And like many of the wicked people do today, they shed blood on their wicked altars. Listen to me. On altars, exchanges are made. When you are not a child of God, or you are a careless child of God, and somebody takes your name to his evil altar, they exchange your blessing and they give you problems. And there you are a careless child of God. You don't take care of your altar, and somebody exchanges your blessing for you. On other many occasions, destinies are determined. Positively, destinies are determined on altars. Negatively, also, destinies are determined on altars. Listen to me, as we came here since 2 days ago, I mean since yesterday, we have raised an altar unto the Lord here. And destinies are being determined here. And that's why you've got to take this place very seriously. When it is time to pray, you pray as if that is the last thing you are going to do. When you want to listen to the word of God, you listen with rapt attention. You don't allow anything to distract your attention. Why? Determine your destiny. Listen to me. Destinies can also be exchanged on altars. Wicked people can change somebody's destiny and replace it. Altar is very important. It's a place where you can determine what will happen to your life. It was on the altar where God told Abraham, your children are going to be strangers in a strange land for 400 years.
Ni ori pepe ni Olorun ti so fun Abraham pe awon omo re yo je alejo fun iriwo odun ni ajeje.
At that time Abraham had not given back to Isaac.
Ni bi ti a tin soro yo Abraham o ti bi
ta. And yet the Lord was speaking 400 and something years ahead of him.
Be ni Olorun soro iriwo odun siwaju.
Because altars are places where destinies are determined.
Nitori wipe pepe je ibi ti a tin pinu ayan
mo. Now when you have an altar that is raised unto the Lord, you can determine your destiny and the destiny of generation coming after you. When you have an altar that is raised unto the Lord, evil destinies of the past, evil, that has been following your lineage, when you have an altar that is raised unto the Lord, you can change that destiny and you can turn it to become a good destiny. Let somebody shout hallelujah. If you are not sleeping, can you shout
hallelujah?
Raise an altar unto the Lord. And I want to tell you, strengthen your altar. Strengthen your altar. Strengthen your altar. Let not your altar be weak. Let not your altar be weary. Because the enemy will always want to weaken your altar. He will not want your altar to be strong. But when your altar is strong, your life is strong. What am I saying? When your prayer life is weak, the devil can easily exchange your destiny. Don't forget what we are discussing tonight. We are talking about the altar. We are talking about the sacrifice and we are talking about the fire or the glory. It is a strong altar that brings down the fire of God. It is a strong altar that brings down the glory of God. When your altar is weak, the glory of God will not manifest in your life as it should be. When your altar is weak, the fire will not come there. The altar is what we are talking about. Let's look at the sacrifice aspect of it. Because
we
are talking about the altar, the sacrifice, and the fire. So what is a sacrifice? Sacrifice is a destruction or a surrender of anything for the sake of something else. You surrender something for another thing. You lay it as a sacrifice. For example, when you say, "I give my life to Jesus," that is a sacrifice. But you cannot keep yourself. You do not have control over your life. You now release it unto Jesus. And then in exchange for that, Jesus releases his life into you. You release your own limited life. You release your own mortal life. You release it unto the Lord. And he gives you his own unlimited life. And he gives you his own immortal life. Why? A sacrifice is when you lay down something in exchange for another thing. It's a devotion of some desirable object in behalf of a higher object. Something that is desirable to you. Something that you really love and you need. But you discover there is something higher than that. You now lay down that one in exchange for the higher one. That is a sacrifice. You do it because you want to claim a more pressing and also that is higher than what you are having.
Oh,
let me tell you, Look at Genesis chapter 8 that we read the other time.
Genesis.
Let's go back there to Genesis chapter 8.
Genesis.
Noah offered unto the Lord.
Noah had to rub us all around.
Genesis chapter 8 verse 20.
Genesis.
The Bible says, and Noah builded an altar unto the Lord.
Bible says, so we pray. Noah said, take my follow.
And then he took of every clean beast.
O si money no era komi ma
gogo. And of every clean fowl.
Ati ninu aye mi
ma gogo. And offered burnt offerings on the altar.
O si ru ebo ore sisun lori pepe na.
That burnt offering is a sacrifice.
Ore ebo sisun yi irubo
ni. I told you an altar is a place where sacrifices are made.
Mo so fun wa wi pe pepe je ibi ti ati ma nse irubo.
When you raise an altar.
Nigba ti o ba gbe pepe.
And you do not make sacrifice on your altar. Your altar will become very weak. Your altar will be gathering dust. Here the Bible talk about Abraham and about Noah. The Bible says he raised an altar unto the Lord. And he offered clean beast and clean fowl unto the Lord on that altar. Now look at the result of that in verse 21. And the Lord smelt the sweet savor, and the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground anymore for man's sake. The Lord has just caused the whole earth and flood has destroyed everything except Noah and his family. But here, Noah raised an altar unto the Lord. And he offered burnt offering on that altar. And the Bible says, change mind. Wow, I don't know whether you listen to that. The Bible said the Lord changed his mind. Meaning that you can make God to change his mind on some issues of your life. Here the Bible said the Lord said, I will no longer cross the earth with flood again. Because the sacrifice that he made was a sweet smelling odor that was unto the Lord.
Nítorí pé ìrúbọ tínú àṣe ó jẹ́ ẹbọ olóòórùn dídùn sí Olúwa.
What are the types of sacrifices that we can make on an altar?
Irúfẹ́ àwọn ìrúbọ tí a lè
ṣe lórí ìpẹ́. Several of them in the Bible.
Ní ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀
wọn. And I don't have sufficient time to be going to one scripture after the other to show them to you.
Mi ti wá ní àǹfààní láti máa ṣí orí Bíbélì lẹ́sẹ̀.
But there is the grain offering.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni a sọ wípé ìrúbọ tó
grain. Grain.
Ìrúbọ tó ní àwọ̀ ewé.
No, not green. Grain. Bí àgbàdo bí.
Okay, ìrúbọ gbìn.
Yes.
Okay.
That is a voluntary offering that we give unto the Lord. It is an expression of your devotion unto God. In the Old Testament, we also have what we call the sin offering. It is for purification of oneself and for the entry into the presence of God. Somebody has run away from the presence of God. And he has been soiled by sin. Now he purifies himself by offering a sin offering. There's a guilt offering. Guilt offering. This is to make reparation for one sin. You have offended God and you are guilty of that offense. The Lord expects them in the Old Testament to make a guilt offering. Many occasions is of monetary value. Then there is a burnt offering which is total unto God. It is for general atonement of sin. When you offer a burnt offering, it is a whole of that thing that you offer that will be burnt as a sacrifice unto the Lord. You don't take part of it.
It's
also an expression of devotion unto God.
There
is also a peace offering. A peace offering is a fellowship offering. Unlike the burnt offering that is totally offered unto God. A peace offering, the Lord takes part of it. The priest that is offering it also takes part of it.
So
it's a fellowship offering. It's a meal that you give back to the Lord and you eat yourself. It's an exchange that takes place, a fellowship between you and your God. Why am I bringing you to all these types of sacrifices that you make?
It's
to let you know that in Christ Jesus, all these offerings have been put together as one. Jesus has been offered as our sin offering. We were guilty of sin. And we're supposed to die. But Jesus has been offered as our guilt offering. Jesus offered himself as a whole burnt offering unto the Lord. And at the same time, there is a peace offering that brings fellowship between us and God, made available by Christ Jesus. The Bible says in Romans chapter 12. Let's go to Romans chapter 12. From verse 1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto the Lord, which is your reasonable service.
Romu orikejila ese ikini nibe ni bibeli ti so wipe litori na mo fi yonu olorun beyin ara ki ayin ki o fi ara yin fun olorun ni ebo aye mimo itewogba eyi ni ise isin ti o tona.
Old Testament, you can offer animal as an offering. You can offer grain as an
offering.
But in the New Testament, the Lord says, offer your own body as a sacrifice unto the Lord. A complete sacrifice unto the Lord. On many occasions in the Old Testament, one of the characteristics of offering on the altar is that you slay that animal, you kill it, it is dead and it is dead.
But
in the New Testament, the Bible says you become a living sacrifice. A holy sacrifice. An acceptable sacrifice. And then you become a reasonable sacrifice.
Bible
says in verse 2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good. Please read verse 2 again.
Ki e ma ti dara yin po ma aye yi sugbon ki e parada lati di titun ni iro inu yin ki ayin ki o le ri idi ife Olorun ti o dara ti o si se itewogba ti o si pe.
When you offer your life as a sacrifice unto the Lord, when you say, I give my life to Jesus, in the Old Testament, when you place an offering on the altar, you don't go back to pick it up from the altar again. It is offered and it is given completely. The same thing happens in the New Testament. When you say, I give my life to Jesus, you give it as a complete offering unto the Lord. You don't take it back again from him. That's why I say, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Three categories of the will of God. The good will of God. Then it graduates into the acceptable will of God. And then it graduates into the perfect will of God. I want to tell you tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the Lord wants you to be a perfect, acceptable sacrifice. It is at that time you'll be able to know the perfect will of God and prove the perfect will of God for your life.
Aram on so fun ni asale yi pe Olorun fe ki e je ebo aye mimo eyi to se tewogba to si pe nigba na le le mo ife Olorun to pe fun aye yin.
How about the fire or the glory?
Ba wa ni ina ti
o the altar, the sacrifice,
irubo,
and the Atina. Let's look at it in 2 Chronicles chapter 7.
Ejeka wo ninu Chronicle keji ori keji.
2 Chronicles chapter 7.
Chronicle keji ori keji.
Verse 1 to verse 3.
Lati ete kini ti ete.
Now when Solomon had made an end of praying, the fire came down from heaven and consumed the burnt offering and the sacrifices, and the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord.
Bi Solomon si ti pari adura igba, iná bọ́ láti ọ̀run wá, ó sì ju ọrẹ sísun àti ẹbọ náà run, ògolúwá sì kun ilé náà.
And the priest could not enter into the house of the Lord because the glory of the Lord has filled the house of the Lord.
Àwọn àlùfáà kò lè wọ inú ilé Olúwa nítorí ògolúwá kun ilé Olúwa.
When you make an acceptable sacrifice on your acceptable altar,
nígbà tí o bá rú ẹbọ tó ṣe ìtẹ́wọ́gbà lórí pẹpẹ rẹ tó ṣe ìtẹ́wọ́gbà,
the Lord comes down.
Fire, iná yóò sọ̀kalẹ̀
láti ọ̀run. And the Lord comes down in fire.
Ọlọ́run yóò sì sọ̀kalẹ̀
láti ọ̀run. The Lord comes down in glory.
Ọlọ́run yóò sọ̀kalẹ̀
nínú ọ̀rẹ́. And the Lord manifests His power in your life.
Ọlọ́run yóò sì fi agbára rẹ̀ hàn nínú
ayé rẹ. Let's look at an example in 1 Kings chapter 18.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká wo àpẹẹrẹ mìíràn nínú ìwé àwọn ọba.
That was talking about the life of Elijah the prophet.
À ń sọ̀rọ̀ nípa ayé Elijah wòlíì.
1 Kings chapter 18.
Àwọn ọba kìíní orí kẹjìdínlógún.
The story of prophet Elijah.
Ìtàn wòlíì Elijah.
On Mount Carmel.
Ní orí òkè Kámẹ́lì.
Let me look at verse 30.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká wo ẹsẹ̀ ọgbọ̀n.
1 Kings chapter 18 verse 30.
Ìwé àwọn ọba kìíní orí kẹjìdínlógún.
And Elijah said unto all the people, come near unto me, all you people, come near unto me, and repair the altar of the Lord that was broken down.
Ǹjẹ́ Elijah wí fún gbogbo àwọn ènìyàn náà pé, ẹ súnmọ́ mi, gbogbo àwọn ènìyàn náà sì súnmọ́, òun sì tún pẹpẹ Olúwa tí ó ti wólulẹ̀ ṣe.
And he took 12 stones according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, unto whom the word of the Lord came saying, Israel shall thy name be called.
Elijah sì mú òkúta méjìlá gẹ́gẹ́ bí iye ẹ̀yà ọmọ Jákọ́bù, ẹni tí ọ̀rọ̀ Olúwa tọ̀ wá wípé Israẹli ni orúkọ rẹ yóò máa jẹ́.
And then he built an altar unto the Lord.
Níbẹ̀ ni ó sì kọ́ pẹpẹ kan fún Olúwa.
And then he told them to lay the sacrifice on the altar.
Ó sì wá fi ìrúbọ náà.
In order,
oh, to one less
he told people to pour water on it. Pour it four times. And the Bible says the water ran about and filled the whole trench.
Bíbélì sọ wípé omi náà sì sàn yí pẹpẹ náà ká, ó sì fi omi kún kòtò náà pẹ̀lú.
When the time of evening sacrifice came in verse 36.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹrìndínlógójì, ó sì ṣe ní ìrúbọ àṣálẹ́.
Elijah prayed unto God.
Ní Elijah wòlíì súnmọ́tòsí, ó sì wípé.
Look at the way he prayed in verse 37.
Ẹ wo ọ̀nà tí ó gbà gbàdúrà.
Look at the 36 and 37.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹrìndínlógójì.
And it came to pass at the time of evening offering.
Ó sì ṣe ní ìrúbọ àṣálẹ́.
That Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am thy servant, and that I have done all these things at thy word. Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that these people may know that thou art the Lord God. and that thou hast turned their hearts back unto you. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice and the wood and the stones and the dust, and it lifted up the water that was in the trench. And when the people saw it, they fell on their faces and they said, "The Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God." What was the controversy here? Who is the Lord? Is it Baal or Jehovah? Elijah said, "Let's settle this matter once and for all." And I said, "You people, prepare an offering, prepare a sacrifice. You prophets of Baal, prepare a sacrifice. I am a prophet of God, I will prepare a sacrifice. The Lord that, and let us not put fire on the sacrifice. Let us pray. The Lord that answers by fire. That is the Lord." And the Bible says here, Elijah prepared the altar of the Lord that was broken down. If you want fire to fall upon your altar, you have to repair the altar of your life. The Bible says he gathered 12 stones according to the number of the children of Israel. Why? Because he wanted to build according to pattern. He built the right altar with the right materials. He put the woods in order. He cut the bullocks in pieces. And then he laid the sacrifice on the wood. The wood there, I see it as representing the word of God. I see it as representing the word of God. I see the sacrifice as representing our body or our life. I see the water representing the Holy Spirit.
Now,
it was when these three mixed together in the right proportion that fell from heaven. When you have the word of God in your life, when you release yourself as a sacrifice unto the Lord, when the Holy Spirit is upon your life, certainly the glory of God will come down. But I want to show you something quickly before I close tonight. In verse 36, I want you to see the prayer that he prayed. It was at the time of evening sacrifice. So he knew the right timing in bringing down the glory of God and the fire of God upon the altar of your life. There must be the right timing. And then he said,
"Oh
God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at thy word." Fire did not fall at that time. Why? I noticed something there. He wanted the people to know God, but he also wanted to be known. He said that they may know that I am your servant. And God kept quiet. Fire did not fall. Look at it in verse 37. He has said the prayer. Look at verse 37. And then he said, "Hear me, O Lord, hear me. That these people may know that thou art the Lord God." And then he removed himself from the scene. "And that thou hast turned their back again." What happened? In verse 38, then the fire fell. When you want the fire of God upon your altar, when you want the glory of God upon your life, God does not share that glory with any man. Get yourself out of the scene. Don't let it to be known that to know. God cannot share his glory with any man. But listen to me. Glory at that time, or fire at that time, can slay somebody. Because we want to share the glory with God.
But
as soon as Elijah removed himself from the scene, the Bible says the fire fell. What was the result? The fire came down from heaven. The people fell in worship of Jehovah. And they confessed, the Lord is God. The Lord is God. And that put an end to the controversy. Tonight, the Lord wants you to raise an altar for him. Because there have been a lot of controversy concerning your life. But if you are going to raise an altar unto the Lord, and you are going to get yourself out of the sin, and you want only the Lord to be honored, I can assure you, fire will fall from heaven. If I, when the fire fell from heaven, it consumed the sacrifice. It consumed the wood. It consumed the water. It consumed the stone. It consumed everything. God took all the glory. And the Lord is looking for somebody tonight who he will take all the glory in his life. Somebody that the Lord will set his fire upon his life. And he will send him into the world. And he will make it to begin to burn the fire of the, to burn the wood of the world, to burn the waters of the world, to burn the stones of the world, to burn the idols of the world, to burn the satanic kingdom, and to bring glory to God. God is looking for that somebody tonight. Who is that person? Who is that person? If you are that person, see your hand up. That the Lord will depend on you. That the Lord will depend on you. And the Lord will set his hand upon your life. Can you rise on your feet if you are that person? If you are that person, let me see you on your feet. Let me see you on your feet. I know not everybody will like it that way. But there are some of us that want to go all the way for the Lord. There are some of us that say, Lord, I want no other thing but your fire. I want no other thing but your glory. I only want to be a vessel that is useful in your hand. Listen to me. Such people, at the end of their life, they become glorious vessels. In fact, in the case of Elijah we saw here, Elijah eventually ended up slapping death. He didn't die. And the Lord is looking for somebody that will swallow death in victory. If you are that person tonight, can you shout to the Lord? Can you say, Father,
Baba,
I lay my life before you on your altar as a sacrifice. Father, cleansing my altar. Strengthen my altar. Make my altar strong. And make me a living sacrifice. Make me an acceptable sacrifice unto you for the glory of your name. Can you pray in the name of Jesus? Can you pray in the name of Jesus? I give my life to you as a sacrifice. I raise an altar unto the Lord. Strengthen my altar, O God. Let my altar be the place where angels will be ascending and descending. Where I will meet with the heavenlies. Where I will meet with the power of the kingdom of God. And bring word from heaven and become a benefit to man. Where I will bring words of men and plead with God on their behalf. That I will be the, my house will be the address of God. My body will be the temple of the living God. That anybody that comes across my life comes across the glory of God. Lord, I release my life unto you. I give myself unto you as a living sacrifice on your living altar. That your living glory will come upon my life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we are praying. If you don't have an encounter with Jesus, if you don't have, you cannot raise an altar unto him, but you become an altar in the hand of the devil. And instead of God manifesting his glory in your life, the devil begins to manifest his glory in your life. But you can put an end to that one tonight. You can put an tonight. If the devil has been the one manifesting his glory in your life,
he's
the one making you to commit sin, making you to do evil, making you to do wicked things that you don't like, and you are saying, Lord, I am tired, I don't want to continue in that direction. If you are in that category, can you lift up your
hands
and you want Jesus to be the Lord of your life? You want your body to become an altar unto the Lord, and at the same time a sacrifice unto the Lord. If you are doing that, can I see you wave your hand? You want Jesus to do that in your life? If you are doing that, can you come forward? I want to pray with you, because the Lord wants to change the destiny of your life. I told you, destinies are changed on altar. Destinies are changed on altar. The destiny the devil has given to you, the Lord is changing it here tonight, because this is an altar. We are the hand of God. Will touch your life. If you are coming, please do it fast. If you are coming, please do it fast. Do it fast. Do it fast. Do it fast. I do not have sufficient time. Please come, 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 come now. Come now, come now, come now. The Lord is going to change your destiny. The Lord is going to change your story. The place the devil has ordained for you before,
whatever the devil at
a, the Lord is changing it tonight. Who is coming again? Who is coming again? Please do it fast. Please do it fast. Please do it fast. The Lord is changing destiny tonight. The Lord is changing destiny tonight. The Lord is changing destiny tonight. Don't sit back there. Change your destiny for better tonight. This is the place where your altar will become the altar of God. Come, please do it quick, do it quick, do it quick, do it quick. This is the time God is changing destiny. The Lord is changing your destination. The devil has that you will go to hell, but the Lord is changing that destination tonight. And he said, I want to take you into my kingdom, and I want to make you my useful vessel. I want to make you my altar. I want to make you my battle axe. I want to make you my weapon of warfare. I want to use you to destroy the kingdom of the devil. The Lord is raising people, and you happen to be one of them. Can you pray? Can you pray tonight in the front? Those who are in the front, can you pray and say, Lord, this is my only one life. Say, Lord, this is my only one life. I yield it to you, Jesus. Please take it over from me. From today, my destiny that has been evil is exchanged for the destiny of Jesus. From today, my life will no longer be a problem to God. I will become a useful vessel in the hand of the living God. Can you pray that prayer in the mighty name of Jesus? Can you please come over? Can you that pray? Please pray that prayer, because the Lord is doing something in your life tonight. The Lord is changing your destiny tonight. The Lord is changing your destiny tonight. The Lord is changing your life tonight. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Pray, say amen as I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for these ones that you are changing their destiny. With their own leg, they walk out tonight onto this altar. By the reason of the grace and the power of God on this altar, every evil destiny that the devil has ordained for your life, we roll them away in the name of Jesus. We place your life as a sacrifice and as an offering unto the Lord Jesus Christ. You remain in his hand, because it is written, I know who I believe, that he is able to keep that which is committed unto him. Because you are committed unto the Lord today, he keeps you for the rest of your life. It becomes the Lord over your life, and the devil can no longer take charge of your life. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. Can you please go to our pastor here? Please put your hands together for Jesus as they go to our pastor. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. I believe God is really helping us with this program as it goes on. We have listened to the message on the altar, the sacrifice, and the fire. We want to pray it now. I believe you have prepared the altar properly. We want to have an encounter with heaven tonight. So we're going to have a prayer session this evening. Please help me just wake up and pray. Like we said, you couldn't have just come from wherever you came from to this camp meeting and sleep. It's an opportunity when you are feeling dizzy or you are dozing, just get up, walk around and open your eyes again and go on, so that you won't lose an opportunity. So we are inviting our pastor, Reverend EUG Igor, for this session. Can we put our hands together for the Lord?
Amen.